ready to go green. 3, 2, 1, the green flag is out. It is time for Stadium Super Trucks Racing race number one.
So down to turn number one. Let's keep it nice and sedate for the first couple of corners here. Wasn't much in qualifying yesterday. A very different looking starting grid. As through turn number one they go, it's Davey Hamilton Jr. aboard the Robbie Gordon number seven truck that leads us through in this long, long straight. Down towards turn number three, Eric Davis, his first front row start in Spin Energy Stadium Super Trucks. But here comes the showstopper. Down the inside already, your two-time champ looking for the pass here at turn number three.
Great news for a lot of these guys, but bad news. Oh, and it looks like Bill Hines gets into his teammate, piles into Paul Morris.
Uh-oh.
The dude gets pushed off the track. Eric Davis, now he drops back a couple spots as well. He has some trouble there. Good news for some of these guys. They got some of the fast, slower guys up front with a lot of room, but you got Sheldon Creed. Sheldon Creed having trouble yesterday, getting into the chicane, getting into a couple of walls, driving with some issues, but now he's starting up front. He's already out in the lead. That is not good news for some of our faster competitors here.
He hasn't been that high up after qualifying since mid-2015
yeah.
coming into today, so he's going to be hard to beat from here. Here's one of the rookies in the field, Brazilian Attila Abreu in the Monster Energy Shell V-Power, number 51, more known for his exploits in the Stock Car Brazil Series. Does a great job with his teammate Ricardo Zonta down there. I'll tell you what, this is a lot of intensity for the first couple of laps here.
Right off the bat, these guys are dropping the hammer. You see big time racing right there for the fourth spot. We see our leader starting to check out a little bit. Three-wheeling right there for Hamilton Jr. Hamilton Jr. running very hard right there. He is in the number 7 Speed Energy truck. Hamilton, he was a late entry. He is the Kevin Howell construction vehicle. That is the big spot for him this weekend, trying to put that Kevin Howell construction vehicle up on the podium. As you see right now, it is Lyondyke and Morris and Creed. They're leaving the pack, but we are too wide right there with Harlan and Hines. As Hines just drops back one spot, Harlan takes that oil purple truck and moves up one more position, puts his eyes on the front of the pack.
Harlan's been impressive in the past couple of rounds of this series, a couple of podium positions in the recent passes. Phil, through comes the field to complete lap number one. We pick up Ari Lyondyke Jr. aboard the Lear Corporation, number 119. The third truck in the Bill Hines three-prong attack this year in the series, with, of course, Paul Morris in the championship as well. There is Hines in the sky blue United Fiber and Data entry, being chased very hard by Matt Brabham in the Devil Biss at number 83.
Bill Hines running really well a couple weeks ago in Perth, Australia, coming out and qualifying yesterday, putting down some good laps. But right now, he's got a lot of pressure with the Bilvis driver right behind him of Brabham. Meanwhile, out in front, good racing going on here between Paul the Dude Morris out of Queensland, Norwell, Australia, and Ari Lyondyke. Kind of maybe some bad blood on the track between these two. We've seen a lot of bumping and rubbing from them. That's good news for Creed. He can just pick his own lines to check out, look in the rear view mirror, and watch these guys battle back and forth. I think they're going to slow each other down.
If you've got an eagle eye and remember what it's like down there at turn number five, you'll see some orange cones that have been placed on the inside of the curb there to stop the drivers attacking those really high and steep curbs down at turn number five. It does slow it down, but it also narrows up any passing opportunities through that part of the race course.
Stadium Super Trucks, of course, always erring on the side of safety, and that's why you'll see those cones in turn number five. They will be penalized for hitting those cones. Of course, erring on the side of safety. Smoke coming off those Toyo tires for Ari Lyondyke as he runs it in really deep in that turn. Starting to get a bit of a gap in between Paul Morris and Lyondyke. Lyondyke in the 119 Lear truck. Keep in mind, Lear, those are the people that are making you comfortable in your vehicle at home, supplying all the seats for all the different manufacturers, car and truck manufacturers around the world. As we almost swap a little bit of paint, there is Harlan getting in the side, into the side of Abreu. Abreu all the way up from Brazil, our first Brazilian driver here in SST, running very well. As you see him almost going three wide, that is Abreu, Harlan, and Brabham. A lot of talent right there from SST, from all different walks of driving life, from off-road, open wheel, South American NASCAR and stock car. A lot of racing experience right there between those three gentlemen.
What about the effort from Gavin Harlan here right now? He's made up five positions. He's up to sixth place now. As through they come, that little chicane here, which was super tight yesterday. We've had to sort of modify that during the course of overnight and into today. We just saw Eric Davis going through the shot there in truck number 75. So Abreu getting a big welcome to Stadium Super Trucks here. The 30-year-old Brazilian sweeps his way through turn number two and down this long straight to turn three.
Abreu is here to win races. This is his first time out. out in Stadium Super Trucks. He's made it a point speaking with Jason Smith and myself and you, and he is very serious about winning. This is not just out to have fun. As you see him putting big pressure on Harlan, not letting Harlan get up on him. The 51 Shell Monster Energy truck stays out in front of Harlan. As you mentioned, Harlan starting all the way back. Gavin Harlan, the young man, he starts all in the back of the pack, qualifying fastest yesterday. He's got his work cut out for him, but he is slowly moving through the pack. Let's not forget, folks, there will be two mandatory competition cautions in this race, which will give these guys an opportunity to pack the pack back up together again. So we do have two more rolling restarts yet to come. One's right around the corner.
Harlan and Brabham might have thought this would be an easy pass going down Avery, but he's got a lot of experience for a young guy, and he's going to make these guys earn this position. Battle for fifth position. Now Harlan switches to the outside here. They're almost going to go three wide down here into turn number seven. Avery locks it up. Same two for Harlan. And where's Brabham going to go? He takes the traditional racing line down there.
Brabham in the driver's meeting saying, hey, is it okay to go to the inside of that curb? Odd to see him not doing it. I think he was just trying to pick a different line, hoping one of those guys would make a mistake. Both of Harlan and Abreu running it in really deep, really hard there on the edge of what's in control and what's out of control. I think Brabham was hoping that one of them would spin out and go to the outside of him, but he ends up not working out for him. So Harlan Abreu still out in front of Matty Brabham in the 83. Really, really good run for Harlan Avery right now. Very impressive stuff.
Absolutely. Down to Motor City Casino corner they come. So working our way towards the first competition caution. It's still Creed from Morris in the Live United Fiber and Data Truck 67. Back to Lion Dyke Jr. in the 119. Then Harlan from the back of the field. Keep in mind, too, folks, there is points for passing trucks and all this. So far, he's got seven added to his total already.
Yeah, that is big. And there's weekend points going on throughout the whole weekend. You get qualifying points. You get points for race one, which we're watching right now, points for race two as well for tomorrow. So he who accumulates the most points at the end of the weekend is crowned the champion here at Belle Isle. So that's good. You got to be smart. You got to be mellow. You got to keep your truck together and last all weekend long and accumulate those points. Avery getting some qualifying points yesterday, being in the top five. So he and Brabham going side by side again. Quite a battle right here. Brabham not leaning on Abreu too much. He's being kind. He's being good. He knows we've got comp cautions coming up. He knows he's got to keep the truck together. So a lot of smart racing from actually all the competitors right now. These guys are playing it pretty mellow, pretty smooth. I think we're going to see them unleash the beast here shortly.
Yeah, the second session, I think, will be the telling point of this race. We're coming up towards the comp caution point. It's on the approach down to turn number seven. So Brabham past Abreu now, but the field's about to stack up at the top of this corner. And so far, it's been clean and green. There's the kiss of death if ever I've said it.
So they should be seeing a comp caution come out soon. And I've got to step back a couple turns right now. Going around turn five just now, we did notice there was an orange cone down. It was down off to the side. Now, we didn't see it here in the commentary booth. I'm curious if it was seen by Jason Smith and USAC in race control or not. If there was, there will be a penalty for taking that out. So we're going to definitely be seeing what's going to happen here in just a moment, find out who that was exactly. As you see these guys right now come around slow, there is the Motor City Casino ramp right there. Motor City being a very kind friend of Stadium Super Trucks from last year and again this year as well. So you see them on board here helping out with Stadium Super Trucks and sponsoring that particular ramp. As this is a moment for the guys to calm down, mellow out for a minute, think about how the first couple laps go. Now keep in mind, folks, we're only a third of the way through race number one here. This is the first of two mandatory competition cautions that you're going to see here in Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks. So now there's time. They're slowing down. Our leaders are down to only about 20-30%. What they're doing is right now letting the guys in the back catch up, and this will be a single file rolling restart, the first of two of these. So this is time for them to calm down, reflect on what happened the first few laps. Where am I fast? Where am I not? You know, where can I make a move on this guy and the next? The key is, Matt Nolte, is keep your truck together. Keep your brakes working well. Keep the tires where you need them to be. They all come out in brand new DOT Toyo tires, just like you put on your pickup at home. That's what they're running here and racing on, really putting a beating on them here. But they got to keep that truck together and ready to go to get all the way through both two of the two restarts so that they can battle for the checkered flag.
And like other categories we have here this weekend, Detroit Grand Prix, these tires come on better the more they're worn down. Yesterday, they're like driving on ball bearings or ice, if you will.
Yep.
The more they wear down, the better they are on this very slippery concrete surface. So truck 50, the Hoff, is going to go back one spot for that issue down at turn number five, just being confirmed by USAC's Jason Smith, who's quite busy next door at the moment getting this all sorted out. The competition course is a little bit modified to what we saw last year, where we'd run to the start-finish line, then do a full lap. We changed that early this year to give us more racing, more so.
Well, that's what it is. Instead of, you know, having the comp caution come out right at the start-finish line, they go all, depending on different tracks, it's different, but, you know, go to turn 7 or 8 or 9 or so and then back it down, and you're exactly right. It gives the fans and the drivers, and us for that matter, more action throughout the weekend up at speed. So as they're getting ready to go, they are going to be getting the rolling green flag here shortly. As you mentioned, Hoffman, he's dropping back one spot. I think that's just going to fuel the fire a little bit. Both the two of our younger drivers, Hoffman and Harlan, quiet guys, quiet kids in the pits, but have really proven that they've got what it takes to be running up front out here in Stadium Super Trucks, both with their first podiums just within the last couple of months. So exciting stuff for them. But Sheldon Creed, we haven't talked about him too much because usually we watch him come through the pack. He's just out front on cruise control right now as they get ready to take the second of three green flags. The flag is off. Sheldon Creed sets the pace real easy, packs him up a little bit, and we are off and going. Couple more laps of wide open action here at Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks.
The trucks were almost at a standstill out of our commentary box position as we go back to green flag racing right now. This is the big shock for everybody that follows this series. Sheldon Creed has never won here in Detroit.
Yeah.
One of the rare tracks he hasn't won on the tour.
Well, and keep in mind, last year was his first, he was only here for the Friday event, and he took off to go home to his senior prom.
That's right, he did.
Yeah, so he wanted to go through with his dancing shoes on instead of racing. Here, he's ready to go. Look at, there's Aaron Bombach. Aaron Bombach, he is a local, he is one of the local heroes here. Super talented driver Bombach is. He's out of Rochester Hills. He's in the Strategic Staffing Solutions truck, that bright green truck. He's been on the podium every year here in Detroit, at least one time. That's what he says his goal is here again this weekend, and he's got the skills and the ability to do so.
If he makes the podium today, they will tear the place down here.
Absolutely.
Everyone from Rochester took the day off yesterday to come down and support the man who's 49 years of age and did a stellar job last year. It's his only appearance. Usually he's hoping to come to Texas. He's hoping to come to Australia one day where we've got many races down there, but he's got some guys ahead of him that are hungrier today, including our man who was quickest in qualifying yesterday, Gavin Hullion, the 17-year-old for Mesa in Arizona. He's taking Brabham with him, but now they close up on the front guys. This is why the comp cautions are so critical.
Look at these guys. You see both Ari Lyon-Dyke Jr., Harlan, and Brabham really pouring the throttle on. They're on the line. Pedal right there, up on three wheels, really letting that truck eat. Those Toyo tires are now, they're heated up, they're getting the power to the ground, and you can see as every one of those Stadium Super Trucks up on three wheels, really pushing forward.
Lyon-Dyke with the support of the Lear Corporation, he's doing double duties here this weekend. He's been driving the two-seater IndyCar, taking some lucky VIP guests around on the Thursday leading into this event. Every time we've seen him, he's in a different shirt.
Yeah.
Now he's back into the overalls and hoping to go one better than what he did last year here at Detroit as they come through to complete another lap. It's the showstopper ahead of the dude, ahead of Junior.
Yep, so big race and a lot of talent. I mean, the who's who of Stadium Super Trucks is right here in the front of the pack. And now I've been saying that, using that term for a call. Look at Abreu up on his lip. And back on Sheldon Creed, our two-time champion in the Safecraft Safety Equipment, number one. Behind him, Paul Morris, Ari Lyon-Dyke Jr. Brabham gets that pass on Harlan. As the camera goes back to see Abreu get rolled over there, we missed that pass. So now Brabham patiently, 3-4 laps, takes his time, finally gets past Harlan. Now is Harlan going to have what it takes to move up in front of him again and take that spot back? He very well may, but the who's who is up here front in Stadium Super Trucks Racing, and I've been saying that for a while now. What I'm adding to that pack is Gavin Harlan. He has proven he's got what it takes to run with these guys. I don't think we're going to see the pack leave Gavin Harlan. I think he's going to stick right in the battle here.
His form has been impressive. Apart from the DNF in race number one at Perth in Australia just a few weeks ago, he has not been off the podium since race number two in St. Petersburg. So the young fella, he earned that qualifying spot yesterday, expecting big things as we get towards the end of the second stage of this race in that second competition caution, not too far away, but a great scrap for the lead here.
And keep in mind, folks, as Matt Nolte was just mentioning here, these guys, they still got to be mellow. They still got to keep the truck together. They're going to want these last couple laps to be able to run this truck into every single turn as deep as they can and keep those brakes working. So they got to run it hard, but they got to keep it back. Maybe, you know, 97, 96% right now is what they got to give, because you're going to give 120% here in the last couple of laps. As we go through the chicane one more time, everyone gets through there good and clean as they are really on the gas coming past the commentary booth. Aaron Baumbach, he's got his eyes set on the leader, so he came by here with authority. He is in between the two packs, kind of all on his own, fresh air underneath of him, open lines as he is watching our leaders out front and wants to be a part of that battle as Gavin Harlan really pushing hard up on three wheels.
That was a great shot, wasn't it, through turn two. They look down towards three. So Creed, he knows it's all premature here. It's going to stack the field up in a moment or so. Here is Leyendyke Jr. looking down the inside of his teammate, Paul Morris. They go side by side in this contact, and Brabham gets into the mix. And look at Harlan. We'll go right through the middle.
Oh, Harlan, he needs to go by a lot ticket today, because he's the luckiest man in Detroit as he gets through that nice and clean. I mentioned earlier on, there is some on-track bad blood in between Ari Leyendyke Jr. and Paul the Dude Morris. Off the track, they're all right. That wasn't necessarily a dirty move, but there was a mistake made, I believe, by Leyendyke. He took out his teammate, Paul Morris, spun them both out. Who capitalizes on that? Gavin Harlan. And now Ari Leyendyke looks like he was frustrated right there. Made another mistake. He may have some damage to the truck from that first spin out, but it's hard to say. But his day today is going in the wrong direction, as Paul Morris still looking decent right now. Matty Brabham, he got in the mix, collected a little bit. Here is your second and final mandatory competition caution. But it's been some good racing, some clean racing, but then all of a sudden, Nalty, that thinks all heck just broke loose.
That was incredible, and that puts Harlan in the box seat. Nine positions he's made up now. He runs second, Morris is third, Brabham in fourth position. Behind them is Aaron Baumbach, he's fifth, and maybe staring down the podium as here's Leyendyke Jr. And what was that about?
I would imagine he's trying to get up front. He might be pulling into pit lane, possibly, to have the truck looked at. That is very possible. You see here, it's just a wild, wild bit of action right there. And here's the replay.
Oh,
all on his own right there. So, I, you know, it's... anyone can make a mistake, no matter how talented of a driver you are. And Ari Leyendyke, he's a great driver. I think there might have been something wrong with the truck there, because he just drove into the wall. I mean, it was almost like he didn't even put up a battle to stay out of the wall. So I would have to think there's something wrong with the Lear entry, the number 119 of Ari Leyendyke Jr. As he pulls into the paddock and into the pit lane here, the IndyCar pit lane, you see the SST technicians and mechanics over there checking it out.
This is not too normal. We don't usually have pit stops in a race like this, but we do have a handful of our guys down there, which work so many hours behind the scenes to get all 11 trucks back on the track. Hopefully, can get back out and join the rear of the field here.
In the history of Stadium Super Trucks, we have only had two competitors pull into the pits, have something serious mechanically done, and finish on the read lap. So here's your replay on the flip. Oh, and looks like Archley goes off the second ramp, couldn't make up his mind. Should I hit it? Should I go around it? They are allowed to miss a ramp if they're erring on the side of safety and safety only. And so he couldn't make the decision if he could go around it or not, decided to only hit it with two wheels, as we saw Craig Dantas do that a few weeks ago in Perth. This is the last and final green flag. They are off and running. This is a sprint to the checkered flag.
Who's going to win this? Two of the youngest stars in Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks, and Leyendyke Jr. is going to join the back of the field here. So well done to the crew getting the Lear Corporation 119 truck back out on the circuit. But it's Creed, it's Harlan, it's the Dude, and Matty Brabham all looking to square off. And we've got our very own Aaron Baumbach here looking for a podium position.
Do not count out Aaron Baumbach. He has been on the podium numerous times here. Look at the Hoff. The Hoff in that True Fuel number 50-1 coming in really hot, putting a lot of pressure on. I think he got by Eric Davis right there. Davis keeping the truck together. Those guys, keep in mind, got another race tomorrow, so they're keeping their trucks looking good, running well, and in shape. But meanwhile, out in front, our leaders are already starting to check out. But as we just mentioned about Baumbach, you cannot count that guy out. He has been on the podium every year here, and I you know what, I would almost put this week's paycheck on it. We're going to see him on the podium before the weekend's over. And just see him right now pushing hard, trying to stay with Matty Brabham. A lot of pressure on the local as he doesn't have the seat time some of these other guys have. I mean, he's only in the truck one weekend a year, but he's able to manipulate that truck and get out of it what he needs.
Does a great job, too, as through the inside against the Corvette wall at turn number 7, the field come and down into the corporate suites in this area. We've got a bird's eye view of these amazing Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks. We wind this race down now. Race number 1, another one to come up here tomorrow at the Chevrolet Detroit Grand Prix presented by Lear. But it's Creed, Harlan, and the Dude, the top three. But that can change in the blink of an eye.
Absolutely. When you've got just outside of the top three, you've got Matty Brabham, you've got Aaron Baumbach right there ready to strike. Anything can happen. And there's still a fair amount of racing left to go before we take the checkered flag here. So body panels are starting to fly. These guys are really pushing it. As I said, they need to save the truck to the last final laps. This is when they are giving it 120%. And I guarantee you, right now, Sheldon Creed says, wow, so the master has now become, or the teacher has now become the master, as he's used to starting in the back of the pack. He looks in his rearview mirror. He knows Gavin Harlan was all the way back starting in 11th in last place. Now in second, and he's like, oh, man, I've spent too much time with this young man. He's on the gas. I know for a fact Sheldon Creed's pushing harder now than he has all day today.
This is the fastest lap. Always the last lap of the race is the fastest in Stadium Super Trucks. They come down to turn number 3. On this, the final lap, Matt Brabham with the Devil Biss truck starting to peel apart there on the left-hand side, and Bumbuck sitting behind the scene. What plays out through the tight and twisty sections around here through turn 4 and 5?
Right now, not too close to one another. In order for something to happen, one of these guys has to make a mistake.
Yeah.
And they're pushing it, so it very well could happen. The cream of the crop has risen to the top, if you could say.
Nice.
Out front right now with our top couple guys. Look at Brabham. There is Brabham goes to the inside of the Dude. The Dude gives him some room. What a gentleman he was right there. I think he's going to try to give it back as Brabham moves into P3.
That was a little too easy. You know, Morris has always got another plan up his sleeve. The former Bathurst 1000 champion back in Australia going side by side with Matt Brabham. He raced against Brabham's dad, Jeff, who's here this weekend. Side by side they go. They're joined at the hip. Oh. Brabham doesn't want to give up. The hip and shoulder goes up from the Dude. It's not over down here into turn number 8.
Brabham stays on the skinny pedal. Back into a little bit of contact there again. Good, clean race right here. Contact is all right. Swap and paint and same Super Trucks is expected.
What's
but Baumbach says, hey, I want to get a piece of this action. That's a guy that hardly ever tears the truck up, but he's willing to swap some paint right now to get into a podium spot.
He could get third here. If these two don't settle down, he's going to nip down the inside. Thought about it down here at the Motor City Casino corner, but I think it's just about done. As down towards the final turn they go, they really let it go here in that last sector of this race. But Sheldon Creed, he's never won here in Detroit. It's going to be a big moment for him too, because this is race win number 30 for the showstopper here in 2017.
That is Safecraft Safety Equipment number 1, Sheldon the Showstopper Creed in P1. Behind him, Gavin Harlan in P2. What a run from last to second place. And Paul the Dude Morris, he finishes just off the podium. Great battle, and Matt Brabham is able to capitalize that. And the DeVilbiss number 83, putting himself in P3. What a run from all these gentlemen. Sheldon Creed, I don't think we've ever seen Sheldon come off the track with such a clean truck.
It's as clean as it gets. I just need to wipe it over when they take it back into the paddock. How about put your hands together, folks, right around this Belle Isle Park circuit. Fantastic race here today. And the showstopper breaks through. It's a drought breaker for Detroit. He's won pretty much on every racetrack we go to in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks. But that is his 30th career win in this championship for a man that's only, well, not even 20 years of age right now. Gavin Harlan, 9 extra points towards his total for this year's championship for the most trucks passed during the race. But Larry, this guy is very, very impressive. The Safecraft number 1 of Sheldon Creed.
Could you guys be a little more excited?
Oh, we'll try.
Would you try that? But I tell you what, that was one heck of a race. I mean, fans, if you were watching, I mean, they're up on two wheels on one side going around corners. They're jumping through the air after each other. They're trading paint. This is something else to watch.
They're
absolutely
impressive. And we've brought them down to Australia numerous times now. They raced in my home city in Perth just a few weeks ago, and the crowds were just gobsmacked at what they saw down there. And they're coming over to Texas next week. We head across to Darwin at the top of Australia the week after that. The series continues to get bigger and bigger, but this guy back in some form. We've seen him in a Trans Am car this weekend too, doing some good things as well.